för CrankItUp. Vi sitter i Studio Fredman inne i Göteborg och har Feed Her to the Sharks på studio. Can you introduce yourself, guys? What do you do?
Okay, no worries. Hey, guys. I'm Andy and I'm the singer.
Daniel and I play bass.
Joey, I play guitar.
Chapman, I play drums.
What are you doing here in Sweden? It's a far away, far trip from Australia.
It is.
Pretty far.
Yeah. What are you doing here?
We're recording a new album that's coming out in 2012. It'll be out. Yeah.
Sometime, we'll come out sometime next year. We're still promoting our previous album, The Beauty of Falling, so we're going to like tour around Australia a fair bit to do that a bit more, and then hopefully that'll pick up the momentum a bit so we can drop the new album. So far so good.
For the people who have listened to you before, do you have any new vibes for the new album, or is it more old stuff? Or
The material, there's pieces of old Feed to the Sharks in there, but it's like, we'll try to go, it's like a fair bit heavier, yeah. And it's a fair bit more catchier, like with melodies and singing as well, so we've just tried to push both extreme, and yeah. It's just an extension, I guess, the best answer that would be, extension of the old CD.
You think you get any of the famous Gothenburg metal sound when you're here in Gothenburg recording it?
Definitely. That's why we're here.
It is.
All the way.
So at least it's what you want when you're coming here.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, Freddie does like an awesome sound, and yeah, it's well worth the journey. Fucking 40-hour trip we came.
How long are you going to be here?
Another 2 weeks.
Yeah, we've already been here for 2 weeks now, so I think we've got another week and a half.
Yeah. Almost a month away.
Yeah.
You think you can do anything good about this then?
Sorry?
Do you get anything good out of this then?
Well, hopefully we get a CD out of it. it's been very enjoyable, the experience. It's good.
Very good.
Do you have any special influences when you writing the songs, or who's writing the songs?
We all do it. We all sort of.
Chewy and Andy are the main songwriters, and then we pretty much just have our parts in there and have our saved stuff. But yeah, they do the majority of the songwriting.
Mm-hmm. So, what's your influences?
Like other bands and stuff.
Everyone's
beer,
different.
Beer, Bacardi,
Elk beer. They're strong, that shit.
It
tastes like shit.
Love it.
Do you know anyone that drinks it?
Me. You all do.
The fucking beer baron.
I don't know. Influences.
As I Lay Dying.
Yeah.
But just In Flames, yeah, Swedish band.
Yeah. Lady Gaga. We like beats, and like we like everything. Like our band, like we listen to like pop, rock, we listen to everything. And we just like collaborate everything, and that sort of makes the sound. And I think you'll hear that more than ever on the new CD, because there's a lot of poppy, catchy stuff, and there's like a lot of brutal stuff. So it's like a combination of everything that we listen to, and that is like Feed Her to the Sharks, so
typical Gothenburg metal sound of it.
Yeah, we definitely like the heaviness.
That's awesome.
I think he's very unique with his style over here, and what we're hearing, like early stages of the tracks at the moment, are it's really impressive. So definitely.
Speaking of original, your band name. Feed Her to the Sharks. Why? Who came up with it?
That was a, who was it at the end of the day?
I think you said Feed Them to the Sharks, and then we changed it to Her or something?
Yeah.
And then you wrote Misery.
Yeah, it was like our first song that we ever wrote. It was called Misery, and that was on the Beauty of Falling, the previous CD, and that was like the first segment or the first passage of lyrics. Mm. And Feed Her to the Sharks, and we thought, well, it's like a fresh name, it's aggressive, like it represents like how brutal we are and the energy that we try to portray through the music. And yeah, we thought it was like a fresh, cool idea, and you know, it was, no one's really got a name like that, and sort of we wanted a name that like someone would remember first off the bat, so I guess it's fairly memorable.
Is there a memory?
Yeah, I mean, maybe not Fear to the Sharks, but like you're that shark band, so there's definitely a definitely a fucking hook there. So
yeah, been here for 2 weeks. I see you around town every weekend for those 2 weeks.
We haven't actually recorded anything. It's been a long barren with our hickey.
We like to party.
Yeah, we like to
Dark
party.
Dark cellar at Rock Bottom.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you like about Sweden?
Rock Bottom is pretty sweet.
Yeah, the rock bar.
The weather.
Like, if you're getting in.
No, we're actually pissed off because it hasn't snowed and we wanted to snow.
Yeah, we wanted to snow. That's the first thing. We wanted to, like, come here straight away, and we're like, alright, where's the fucking snow? Where is it?
We were gonna bring like snow boots and stuff, like, we were expecting it to be like.
We wanted to snow angels and snowmen.
He packed the most ridiculous snow gear whatsoever. Yeah. Like massive snow boots. He would look like a fucking alien. Walked off the plane like an astronaut. Everyone in Gothenburg would have went, who's this dude? But lucky you didn't do that, man.
I know,
that's for the best, man.
I hope so.
Crazy.
So what are you doing when you're not recording now?
Playing Call of Duty.
Yeah.
That's all we've been doing. Yeah.
We've been going out a few times and
we're not going out.
Yeah,
we're not
making it out.
We're not making it out.
We're not making it out. Yeah. That's the big thing.
Yeah. Your police, yeah, they're really strict around here, aren't they?
Yeah, the police don't like me. It sucks.
Is it that weird when you drink a whole bottle of Bacardi before you go out?
Well, in Australia, everyone like stumbles around the city and like you can just pretty much do what you want, and the police just keep walking. It was on the street about 10 seconds, and the police had him in a fucking wrist hold, about to beat the shit out of him. So yeah, it's a bit more strict, your system.
Just maybe you look like a person you have to get in jail.
Oh well, that's it.
What's the part?
You get that a lot.
Yeah. So how do you like working here with Frederick and Henrik?
Loving it. It's good.
Yeah, no, it's great.
They're very easy to work with.
They're both just like amazing producers. And it's good to work with them. Yeah.
We didn't know what to expect as well, like coming all the way out here. And especially with all the bands they've recorded, we were expecting it to just be like, you know, really full on.
But yeah, a bit overwhelming and stuff like that.
As soon as we met them and started pretty much tracking, it was this. I guess they're like just another one of us, mates that are tracking for us, more experience, so it's good. They're awesome.
Mm.
Yeah. Good mentors too.
Yeah, they're making it really easy, so it's good.
That's how it should be.
Yeah.
It's easy, it's good. It's good. So when you're done with this album, you're expecting a worldwide tour? Just the one in Australia?
We want to. Like our short-term goal is to get more exposure in Australia, and then we want to come over to Europe. We want to do US as well, you know, as soon as we can. Our management has advised us to do a few more tours in Australia just for the time being, but definitely we want to tour a lot more.
Yeah,
and Europe, I think, especially because it's, you know, like heavy metal is very big in Europe, so yeah. We'd love to come out here and play shows.
You're out having fun. You're at Rock Bottom. You learn some Swedish sentences.
We
know you have a good one.
No, I can't remember how to say it. I can't remember.
You remember it.
I don't at all. Can you repeat it?
Try it.
I don't even know how it starts. Dit.
Jävla.
Jävla.
Rövhål.
Rövhål. Oh, that's right.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
You were the one coming out like, "Ditt jävla
rövhål." How do you say dick in Swedish?
Kuk.
Kuk.
Kuk is. No, flensus.
Flensus.
We were at the
Yeah.
We were at the pizza store, and Freddie was like, you should ask for Flens Oost on your pizza. We're like, what does that mean? Yeah. We found out what it meant.
He tried to pass over the prick.
Yeah. Awesome.
Did you get it?
Oh, like dick cheese, yeah. Of course.
And how about your snooze?
Oh, snooze.
You have the best snooze story.
Yeah, I, this Gothenburg's, how do you say it, Rabe?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to the counter to get this, and Freddie was like, just ask for what you call it, you know, how you spell it. And I was like, okay. So I went to the counter and asked her for some Gothenburg rape, because that's how it's spelled. She wasn't happy. She just kind of stared at me and was like, what? And I was like, Gothenburg rape, you know? Can I have some? That blue rape over there. And then Freddie had to barge in before she called the police.
Called the police.
It didn't go down well at all, but...
Fuck
yeah. Yeah, it was...
At least the police is like you here.
Yeah. they're starting to get the hang of us. Slowly.
Yeah, they know us.
What should we look out for
us coming over here next year, because we want to. Yeah. We definitely want to come out to Europe next year and tour Europe and do a brutal tour with cool bands. We're looking forward to that. Okay, we're feeding to the sharks. Alright, we're feeding to the sharks.
And you're watching Crank It Up.
Crank It Up.
That was shit. That was shit.
We had to scream it.
We're feeding to the sharks, and you're watching
Crank It Up.
You're watching Feeder to the Sharks.
You're watching Feeder to the
Sharks. Crank it up! Alright, we're Feeder to the Sharks and you're watching Crank It.
Crank It.
Crank It.